control unit. Okay, next. Okay, what is control unit? Control unit is for the short term ECU, is a digital circuitry contained within the processor that coordinate the sequence of data movement into, out of, and between processor many subunits. Okay, this result of this result data movement through which various digital circuit or in the bracket subunits within the processor produce the manipulated data expected by a software instruction loaded earlier likely from memory. Okay, control unit also control or we call it conduct data flow inside the processor and additionally provide several external control signal to the rest of the computer to further direct data and instruction. Okay, next. Okay, this is a lot of function for the control unit. First of all, the function of control unit is to run the whole computer and control unit is run by the instructions stored in RAM and ROM. So, control unit receives instructions which are stored in RAM and ROM and control operation of other connected unit or device through those instructions. Okay, this is all the function. So, the function of control unit can be categorized into following 5 category. Okay. Control unit operation. Micro operation, the fetch cycle. The first of all is memory address register, or we call it MAR. Connected to the address line of the system bus, it specifies the address in memory for a read or write operation. Okay, secondly, memory buffer register, MBR. It is connected to the data line of the system bus. It contains the value to be stored in memory or the last value read from memory. Okay, the third one, program counter or PC. Hold the address of the next instruction to be fetched. Lastly, is instructive register or IR. Hold the last instructive fetch. Okay, next. This is the cycle. The indirect cycle is once an instruction is fetched, the next step is to fetch source operand. Continuing our simple example, it let us assume one address instructive format with direct and indirect addressing allowed. If the instruction specify an indirect address, then an indirect cycle must precede the execute cycle. So the interrupt cycle is at the completion of the execute cycle, a test is made to determine whether any enabled interrupt have occurred. If so, the interrupt cycle occurred. The nature of this cycle varies greatly from one machine to another. The third one is the instructive cycle. Okay, this cycle, sometimes we call it a fetch, decode, execute cycle. It is the most basic operational process of the computer. It's also a process which the computer retrieves it from a program instruction from the IT memory. It also can be determined from action of the instruction dictate and carry out those action. Okay, next. Micro operation, the fetch cycle. An instruction cycle that sometimes called the fetch, decode, execute cycle. This is also the basic operational process of the computer. It's also the process which the computer retrieves a program instruction from its memory. It's also determine what is the action of the instruction dictate and also it carries out those action. Okay, next. This is the graph how the fetch execute cycle work. So the first, we can see that the pictures, RAM, control unit, LAU, all of the system store, fetch, decode, execute, it will go wrong. So memory address register, MAR, in a computer, the memory address register or MAR is a CPU register that either store the memory address from which data will be fetched to the CPU or the address to which data will be sent and stored. Okay, in the other word, MAR also hold the memory location of data that need to be accessed. We can see that in the graph, how the RAM do the works. It store and then it fetch and then it will decode. When it reading the memory data addressed by MAR, it fed into the MDR or memory data register and then used by the CPU. Okay. When writing to the memory, the CPU wipe the data from MDR to the memory location whose address is stored in MAR. MAR, which is found inside the CPU, goes either to the RAM, or we call it random access memory or cache. Okay, the memory address register is half of minimal interface between a micro program and computer storage. The other half is a memory data register. Okay, pause.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Helmi and today I will present about memory data register. In short form is MDR. Okay, a memory buffer register, MBR, or memory data register, MDR, is the register in a computer's processor or central processing unit, CPU, that store the data being transferred to and from the immediate access storage. It contains the copy of designated memory location specified by the memory address register. It acts as a buffer, allowing the processor and memory units to act independently without being affected by minor differences. In operation, a data item will be copied to the MBR, ready for use at the next clock cycle, when it can be either used by the processor for reading or writing, or stored in main memory after being written. For program counter, this is called in short form is PC. The program counter, PC commonly called the instruction pointer, IP, in Intel x86 and Intel Itanium microprocessor, and sometimes called the instruction address register, that is IAR. The instruction counter, or just part of the instruction sequencer, is a processor register that indicates where a computer is in its program sequence. For IR, that is instruction register. In computing, an instruction register is the part of a CPU control unit that holds the instruction currently being executed or decoded. Next. So we can see the data flow in direct cycle. The IR is examine if indirect addressing, indirect cycle is performed. Yeah, we can see that the rightmost n bits of MBR transfer to MAR, from MBR to MAR, the control unit requests a memory read, and the result is address operand move to MBR. Next is the interrupt cycle. We can see this from control unit go to PC, from MBR go to PC, MAR, and go to memory. Address bus, data bus, and control bus. Next. The fast execute cycle, as you can see, the instruction is transferred from the memory to the processor by using the data bus, fetch. It is stored in MDR. From here to here, this is address bus, data bus, control bus, electronic clock, ALU, and other register. Next. Control of the processor functional requirement. With the information at hand, the following three-step process leads to a characterization of control unit. We can define the basic element of processor, describe the operation that the processor performs, determine the functions that the control unit must perform to cause the micro operation to be performed. We have already performed step 1 and step 2. Let's summarize the result. First, the basic functional element of the processor are the following. First is ALU. After that, register. Third, internal data path. Fourth, external data path. And last, control unit. Some talk should convince you that this is a complete list. The ALU is the functional access of the computer. Register are used to store data internal to the processor. Some register contain status information needed to manage instruction sequencing. As example, a program status word. Other contain data that go to or come from the ALU, memory and I/O modules. Internal data path are used to more data between register and between register and ALU. External data path link register to memory and I/O modules, often by means of a system bus. The control unit cause operations to happen within the processor. First, the execution of program consists of operations involving the processor element. As we have seen, this operation consists of sequence of micro operations. All micro operations fall into one of the following categories. First, transfer data from one register to another. Then, transfer data from register to an external interface. For example, system bus. Then, transfer data from an external interface to a register. Perform an arithmetic or logic operation using register for input and output. Next. So, the control unit perform two basic tasks. There is two basic tasks. First, sequencing. The control unit causes the processor to step through the series of micro operations in proper sequence based on the program being executed. The second is execution. The control unit causes each micro operation to be performed. Next. So,
okay, now my name is Muhammad Khairul Nizam and I will present about the control unit and inside the control unit. So as we can see, this is the diagram for the control unit. Okay, next. Okay, first the input. The input, we have four input. The first is clock. Clock causes a set of simultaneous micro operations to be performed. Second, instruction register. Opcode and addressing mode of the current instruction are used to determine which micro operation to perform. The third is flag. It is used to determine the status of the processor and the outcome of previous ALU operation. And the lastly, for the input is control signals to control and to give signal to the control unit. And then for the output, the first is control signal within the processor. It is those that cause data to be moved from one register to another, and those that activate specific ALU function. And then control signal to control bus, control signal to memory, and control signal to the input-output modules. Okay, next. Okay, this is the flow of the information and go to the control unit. Next. Okay, with each clock cycle, control signal go to the three destination. The first is data path for each path to be controlled. A switch. Data path is a switch. A switch CI temporarily open the gate to let the data pass. Second is ALU. ALU gives signal, activate various logic circuit and gates within the ALU. And the third is control signals. and system bus. Control signals are sent out onto the control lines of the system bus. For example, memory read. Control unit now step of the instruction cycle. The first step, base sequence of control signals are emitted, causing micro operation to occur. And then system clock pulse are used to time the sequence of the events. Okay, next. Okay, this is the example of the micro operation. Okay, and this is the hardware implementation. There are two categories: hardware implementation and microprogram implementation. Okay, the hardware control unit. In the past, hardwired control unit is very difficult to design. Hence, its engineering cost a very high. Presenting the emphasis of computer design is the performance. Therefore, hardwired design is the choice. Also, the CAD tools for logic design have improved to the point that a complex design can be mostly automated. Therefore, almost all processors of today use hardwired control unit.
This is continue about a hardwired control unit. Starting with a behavioral description of the control unit, the state diagram of micro operation is constructed. Most of state are simply driven by clock and only transition to the next stage. Some states branch to different states depend on conditions such as testing conditional code or decoding the instruction. Next. Microprogram control unit. Maurice Wilk invented microprogram in 1953. Microprogram control unit is actually like a miniature computer which can be programmed to sequence the pattern of control bits. Using microprogram, a control unit can be implemented for a complex instruction set which is impossible to do by hardwire. Microprogram approach for control unit has several advantages. First, one computer model can be microprogrammed to emulate other model. Second, one instruction set can be used throughout different models of hardware. Third, one hardware can realize many instruction sets. Therefore, it is possible to choose the set that is most suitable for an application. Require a high speed memory, which was not possible at that time. The reason for speed is that as the control unit determines how fast a sequence of operation can be executed, the bottleneck becomes the speed of accessing the microprogram, which is stored in a special memory. Next. How microprogram work? A microprogram control unit consists of micro PC, micro memory, output buffer, and a sequencing unit. Each word of the micro memory is separated into several fields used for internal control. External control, conditional, and specifies the next address. Internal control bits are the signal that control the data path. External control bits are the signal that control external units such as memory, read, write, interrupt, acknowledge, and any others. Conditionals are the bits that are used to determine the flow of a microprogram. Loop, branching, next instruction, and any others. This input comes from the data path, usually from the conditional code register. Next address determines the next micro word to be
incremented.
Next.
What is horizontal? So, basically, horizontal is described as a microprogram in which there is a one-to-one relationship between internal or external control bits and the actual control signal of the data pad. The micro word can have other format. There are several possibilities. Such as single format, one address, as just described above, as just described below before. Second, single two address. Each micro word contain two next address field, one for result of test true, the other for result test false. Number three is multiple format. Such as one format for the control base without the next address field, and another format for jump on condition with the address field. The advantage is that the micro word can be shorter than the single format. The disadvantage is that to jump will take one extra clock. Okay, realization of micro program system. An assembly of logic element, whether combinational, is called a hardwired logic. By incorporating memories and the system, and the content of memory is the test of assignment elements, the system is called a microprogram logic system. The content is the microprogram. A microprogram system can be used to realize a synchronous sequential system can be used to implement a control unit. Equivalence of hardware and software. The definition of microprogramming is due to Weitz, who in 1953 suggested a method for designing the control unit of a processor. Based on the use of sequence of micro word, a micro program held in a read-only memory, ROM. In this context, microprogramming is generally understood as the technique of producing interpreter for higher level language. At the time when the access memory RAM that was available was much slower than the processor, led to CISC to achieve high speed. The microprogram of CISC are organized horizontally. The need to control a complex processing unit require over micro word to consume a large number of bits, often over 100. Next. Okay. So, conclusion. Because of limit of resource, the number of transistors in a chip, hardwire control was implemented and the instruction set architecture was toward a simple design. The advantage of simpler design for control unit and ease of change popularized microprogramming. Microprogram made possible to achieve more complex instruction sets.
We get a weakness. You gotta see this. Yeah. I remember syrup sandwiches and crime allowances. Vanessa nickel with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan where my accountant lives. In fact, I'm down in this. You say with my boobay tastes like.